Hello and welcome to a little update on the Super Nintendo tracker project that we've been working on, myself and Ferris of Elix. And you can see here we're getting a bit serious now. We've got the NTSC test unit. The Super Famicom is our unit of choice for testing NTSC. And you can see we've got a couple of revisions of the Euro and Australian models of the Super Nintendo 2. In particular, I've been experimenting recently with short samples, so using single cycle waveforms or maybe two or three cycles, in particular at 512 samples in length, or in 256 samples length, or 64 samples, or 128 samples. So these are very indicative of the traditional chip sound you would get, where you're just using simple waveforms. But of course, putting it onto the Super Nintendo, you've got the bitrate reduction, because it's a sample-based unit. It's it doesn't actually generate the sound itself, apart from the noise channel, which we'll get to. And you can see with this, the bitrate reduction codec that's built into the Super Nintendo, how it stores its audio waveforms, corrupts the waveform in very interesting ways. Kind of colours the sound and gives it this slightly gritty edge. It doesn't sound as bad as it looks. It kind of adds this nice aesthetic to the sound. And because the way the Super Nintendo downsamples, it actually has a filter, so a lot of those sharp sounds that you'd expect from the resulting waveforms actually get kind of smoothed out. So you get a very interesting sound out of the Super Nintendo as a result. Anyway, I'll hit play on something I've worked on. It's a very simple track, so literally a test track to check what it sounded like with layering eight of these waveforms together and putting together a little tune. So enjoy. Yeah.